ties to.
Let's do another test here. I did a full restart, so let's see what happens. It seems like it's just cutting in and out. I'm sorry, everybody. It seems to be happening right in OBS. Is the audio cutting out? Still cutting out a lot. Audio is good. Oh, it might be something with OBS then. Well, I guess stream is canceled until I can get that figured out. I don't know why it's doing that. I'm sorry, everybody. I'll try to get it going. Let me see how the okay, let me test that out. Photoshop has got this new document thing here. Save. Oh, it's cool, you can save things up. Okay, I'll try one out. Maybe it's just the camera. I'm just kind of scribbling some text over here to see what it does. Okay, so it's just the camera? Well, that's not so bad then. I'm using the same thing. Maybe I need to get a real camera. Oh yeah, it's running smooth. Okay, well I guess it's just the camera's pooping out on me. Well, maybe I'll just remove the camera then. Oh, look at that. It is super smooth. Oh, okay. Well, it's just the camera then. That's good to know. Let's see. What was I going to do? I was actually thinking of just doing some thumbnailing today or some doodling or drawing. I didn't really have anything planned. I actually just got floors all done and everything like that, so should we go with camera or just cut it out completely since it's being such a butt? It's always raining. I don't know if I like this new Photoshop. Well, I guess it's probably pretty good. I just have to get used to it. Let's see. I'm gonna do 6x2. Set up a little canvas here. Choppy Tim's fine. Well, how's it going, everybody? How has everyone's week been going? I had a pretty good extended weekend, a little extra vacation. And then finally convinced my people that run the apartment to finally give me some new flooring. They did not want to do that for a long time. It seemed like, I don't know, maybe it was probably just a bunch of miscommunication, as per usual. Hey George. Well, that's good. It's good to hear. Yeah, I was gonna do some doodling. I was thinking about using a square brush. Got this square brush right here. I saw some square brushing earlier and I was like, that looks fun. So I might do that. And I was thinking maybe I'll just do kind of I'm gonna change my brush without the switch. Oh. Oh god, Trumplet. Oh, I don't even. Oh. Why, America, why? Yeah. All good, been trying to catch some good new keys since last week. I've been doing pretty good. The new flooring, though, it's. Gotta say, it's kind of giving me a headache. Yeah, I'm just doing environment thumbnails, and so this might be a good thing for you since you said you're not sure what to draw. I'm also not sure what to draw. And that happens a lot. So, I mean, if you're in a position where you're really stuck, you don't know what to draw, just kind of start exploring shapes, really basic shapes you can explore, you know, triangles. Squares, all kinds of things. Or you can go really organic. And right now, basically what I'm doing is I'm just breaking these up. You can't see it on my other screen. I could move the chat over, but basically I'm just kind of placing different layers to be the different like foreground, midground, and things like that. And I'm just kind of plopped those into the environment and coming up with basic shapes and everything. If midway through the stream I start hallucinating, it's because of the floor glue. It's pretty intense smelling. I was getting a headache, but I counteracted that by taking some ibuprofen or something. So, who knows where it'll lead me now. But yeah, I'm just thinking maybe I could do ruins or loads of thumbnails. Yeah, that's good. Nothing that you take to the next stage. Yeah, as long as you're working at something, it doesn't necessarily, you don't have to have everything you do doesn't have to be a finished product. That's good to remember. Actually, I'll post, this is gonna be foreground, I'll put this on the midground kind of. And yeah, I'm just looking at a few references here, like I'm looking at some Viking stuff and some mountains and things like that. And just trying to come up with something that something that'll work. I'm just thinking about composition mainly. So how's everyone else been doing? Is everyone hey Xenomoss, what's going on? Welcome to the stream. My camera's all goofy, so no need to waste energy explaining my terrible camera right now. You know, I need to actually invest in a legitimate webcam. I've been just using a just my phone. Which, speaking of phones, I got a Google Pixel. I suppose I could try hooking that up, but I might just get like a plain webcam, something nice and simple, just to toss in there. Don't worry about so much. But yeah, I was out of town for a while and everything like that, so I was kind of in a standstill on my tutorials and things like that. But I will get back into the mix pretty soon here. Just have to start working on those again. I decided to get going back on the tutorials. I gotta finish off those tree tutorials. You know, everybody's been wanting them. I gotta get them done. But yeah, right now I'm just thinking basic compositional elements and shapes and things like that. You know, maybe I could. I'm kind of fudging the layers a little bit. Like I have this in the front layer and this is kind of mid layers. Maybe I'll just combine that so I don't worry about it as much. And I'm just gonna push this a little bit darker. Hey, Nate Master Flash, what's going on? Welcome, welcome. Aw, your cat's there too. Awesome. I've got my cat, he's sleeping out on the couch in the other room. Exploring shapes. Do you have like a basic idea? You know, I don't really have any idea right now. I'm just exploring shapes. Trying to see my keyboard. Voice is a tad too low. Let me check that. There we go. I turned up the voice. Wait, what? Desktop audio. I have like, oh wait. Hey! Thanks for the host, Real Llama. I'm confused because I have like double mics and stuff. It says starting soon. Oh wait. Oh, here we go. I'm kind of a little confused by audio seems good now. Themes within painting. I mean, I can paint grass and paint landscape and all, but struggle with what kind of world or what building I should have in it. My imagination is really small these past days. If you're having a hard time with your imagination, just don't focus on imagination. Try focusing on just creating you know, replicating worlds, maybe taking a take a break and just focus on lighting and composition. Take a break from something that's giving you a rough time and see where you can take that. If that's still giving you a hard time, try maybe doing some frame stills or something like that. Like a lot of times I'll draw frames from movies I enjoy or something like that, and that'll be something that I kind of push with, and things like that'll help you kind of open up your imagination a little bit. So just remember, you know, you can't be expected to think of everything right away, so try giving yourself a break if you're putting too much pressure on yourself just for coming up with all these, like coming up with the correct lighting and all that stuff. Just kind of pull back from that. Yeah, polish your fundamentals, work on something you know, or keep doing thumbnails, but maybe do thumbnails where you are looking at, you know, like replicating mountains or something, and say there's a movie you really like, and you really like the filmography and whatnot in there, or the kind of look of everything. Maybe jump into there and consider just doing a few frames, copies of those. And, you know, if you post that stuff, obviously let people know that that is, you know, isn't your original work or anything. You're just kind of exploring stuff. But yeah, try doing that. Yeah, I'm making a stick man here. We give stick man a big shield. Maybe it's a Viking stick man. It's got horns. But yeah. It's okay, Sri Lama. I like the one-person host. I appreciate it. So, you know, I, Dolva King. So I've got this little, these formations. They could be ancient ruins. They could be objects. They could be all any kind of thing. So right now, I'm not even thinking what these things are either. I'm just gonna place them more as size reference, like, this is starting to give more of a sense of scale all over these things. You know, you can start looking at this and be like, oh, it's, you know, it could be anything. So make sure and keep your mind open about things like that. And I just find if you don't put too much pressure on yourself, you're going to get much better work done. I know when I get, sometimes if I get a new client or something like that, I'll put too much pressure on myself to get perfect results. So I'll go about, instead of working on what, you know, the client wants me to work on, I'll take a break from working on a client and go and do my own thing for a little bit, build up some confidence, build up some ideas and things like that. And then I can come back and work on their project with much better fervor, passion, and ideas and things like that. So yeah, you're throwing some stuff together for your updated portfolio? Yeah, I'd love to check it out. It's kind of a casual stream today. I mean, not that any of my streams are all that non-casual, I guess, but I just kind of want to keep pretty low-key today. Yeah, and just throwing in some different landscapes and things like that. Doing a slightly different aspect ratio as well. I'm trying out this little square brush here.
But yeah.
That's good. That's awesome. Hey, Elliot. Thank you. Thank you. Just, I hit save, but my computer's not reacting. The casual stream. There we go. Doodle dee doo. There we go. And I could maybe I'll do like some selection based stuff too in here. I could instead of just using a brush for everything, maybe I'll go in and this time I'll. The rain is always a lie. Even real rain is a real lie. Hey Zarenth, how's it going? Oops. So now I'm just gonna. I'm gonna do some selection stuff. I'm just throwing these in here. It's gonna be kind of in the distance. And then maybe. This one's a little darker, so I'll pull it forward a little bit. What is real is the real question. Yeah, and then, hey, there's a leak in my ceiling from a toilet above me, so this rain is very real. Nah, I'm just kidding. We're kind of making your concepts in 3D, as I told you. Oh yeah. Oh, cool. Which name did you tell me that on? Because there was three or four people that were doing that. One of the people I was going to give a PSD, but I just got my computer set up about half an hour ago, so that didn't happen yet. Well, I'd love to see how it's looking, if you have anything. The rain mic. Okay, cool. Yeah, I remember. Yeah, I had someone ask about, so you asked about the Halloween scene, someone else asked about another one, and then there was another scene, I think, too. That's really cool that people are inspired enough to work on that. I am in a different location. It's essentially the mirrored room that I was in before. This was a spare bedroom, but it was just chucked full of crap. And now I took the, I was getting the floors redone, and I took that opportunity to move into this room and have it be like more of a full-fledged studio, because before my studio, it was just sitting in my bedroom. This way, you know, I don't have to wake people up and stuff when I'm streaming or playing games or things like that. You just started doing some basic models and shapes. Okay, cool. But yeah, so I just got set up in here, so it's really. Really newly located. But yeah. Yeah, I might just do these all in one layer so I don't. Well, I don't know. Maybe I shouldn't. I don't know. Going through and deleting this stuff. Maybe I will start out with, I was going to do a mountain. Yeah, I'm going to do a mountain. So I want to start with kind of this dark gray color here. I was actually watching Bob Ross today. I was curious his approach to mountains, but man, that guy really took advantage of his media. Like, he would just throw a brush down and it just became a mountain. He didn't have to use nearly as many strokes. 10 minutes ago. Hey, I literally just started out and I'm showing it. Just kidding. I'm just kidding. Well, as you progress with it, I'd love to see how it's turning out. Are you going to document your progress on it? Because that would be really cool. I like seeing kind of process stills and things like that. Oh, they're always really cool. Really funny thing about my streaming right now, I have the window open so people outside can listen to me, which I find kind of strange for some reason. I don't know why. No, not necessarily. It depends. I usually go with color. Black and white stuff I usually do for just working on compositions and things like that. I usually just recreate it, like I'll model it out or draw it out or whatnot. So I don't really use that too much. Though I did recently possibly, oh no. I recently did some colors on top of black and white stuff, and it sort of worked out pretty good. Ah, German time zones. Yeah, you have to take a special approach to it.
I need to do these. I always end up doing thumbnails with just line work.
Yeah, you know what I have to really get back in the process of doing is color thumbnail work. Maybe I'll just do that, you know? I'm gonna be honest, I was avoiding it for a little bit, just I don't know why, but why not just do straight color? Maybe I'll do that. Oop, I had flux on in it. It messed with my colors. Okay, let's grab this. Maybe I will just do some color ones over here. Though with color, you have to tend to think about things a lot more. I was following someone on Twitter, and she was doing just amazing work with just adding, just doing tons and tons of color thumbnails. It was really, really inspirational, so I should probably start doing some of that too. Hey, Scratch, how's it going, man? Glad you joined me. Yeah, I'll do the other three in color. Why don't I do it this way, the kryptonite drawing painting. Kryptonite! A second here. Oh, cool. Well, thanks for stopping by. My camera's a little screwy right now, but seems like it's working out all right. Other than that, I should say. Just doing some thumbnailing. Trying out a square brush. Though, as I've... Oh yeah, you do need to get your stream going. Scratch is another concept artist I know. He's really good at like architectural stuff and really good at like a lot of value studies and things like that. Scratch, you should post your work there. You want to show it off. He's got some amazing work. He's been incorporating some really cool modeling and stuff together. He uses 3D coat though, so his models look much better and more detailed than the stuff I do. Which I keep meaning to learn 3D coat more in depth, at least. I have like a working knowledge of it, but I'm not that comfortable with it yet, so I need to get in there and just focus on that.
But yeah. Scratch is usually the one that shows me all these cool little techniques and tricks and things like that. I'm kind of fidgeting with little details too much. I'm just gonna go right into color. Let's see. Or try to at least. Screw this black and white. So usually when I do color stuff, I haven't done color thumbnailing in a long time. We'll just throw color like that, choose slightly different lighter color to add kind of a gradient. Knitted mittens! How's it going? Random venting, I hate selling things on Craigslist, people always. Yeah, I don't know what happened to nice and respectful people. That's a good question. So now maybe I'm just gonna do this in layers. I'm gonna do 1, 2, and 3. And I'm actually gonna, like, I have these out as like frames. I'm gonna do this differently though, because it's really annoying dealing with frames. So I'm actually gonna go in here, or not frames, but the opposite of such. So I'm actually gonna make a layer on top of everything. And now, where almost, oh, whoops. Deleted all this stuff for some reason. Oh, here we go. And then go here. Selection. There we go. Now I can just paint right behind it. Well, I didn't even see what we actually typed. I read it as such sticks. No worries. So this should. Yeah, now I can just paint behind it. Yeah, he's got some great stuff out there. We're gonna get to see his process soon because he said he's gonna start streaming, right? Right, Scratch? Eh? Eh? When are you gonna start doing that? So I'm gonna do kind of a darker foreground color, and this will be kind of. This would be basically my grassy areas and things like that. Throw that down, and then I want to do sort of a purpley color, a base color for the stone here. And then desaturate quite a bit. It's a little too much, a little darker. And I'm basically just going to be doing kind of the same thing, but you know, I'm still exploring shapes and things like that. I don't really have too much in mind right now. But this time, it'll have depth. And I'm going to make a layer behind here. And this is going to be kind of just like a distance layer. So if you notice, like, I kind of blended those colors together to get my atmosphere. Yeah. Hey, as long as he doesn't compete with my stream. I'm just kidding. So I'm just thinking some mountain landscape things. Maybe I'll have like this. These are always fun. Maybe kind of this centered focal point area thing over here.
Yeah, there's something wrong with my camera completely. I almost didn't stream because I thought it was my whole stream lagging, but apparently it's just my camera. So try to ignore it and just think I'm a robot or something like that. Maximum duty! How's it going? We're gonna do that, and then on top here, I've got this kind of, I'm thinking of this as almost like my brown color or something like that. Now I'm just gonna figure out a nice grass color and basically paint on top of that. Maybe I'll go with kind of a blue grassy color and sort of stroke the, slide that in here and look a little less green. Nice and vibrant. I'll never paint rain. I'll never forgive rain. I don't know. I can paint rain anytime, I guess. I just hadn't thought about it. Have you ever seen the rain? Something, something. A sunny day. And just throwing in some shadows and things like that. We'll have a little bit of a shadow here casting across the grass. And then we're gonna do some highlights and color here. So we've got these big blocky shapes. They don't really have much form to them yet. They don't even have really much lighting to them yet either. I'm gonna start breaking them up, adding some lighting, add some little bits on the ground, and I think you have to type gamble. Now I'm just gonna get a little bit of the gambling has begun. Whatever you do on your stream, Scratch, don't add gambling. It doesn't end well. Or do. That's what I'm imagining is happening to my camera. So much gambling is going on, I don't even know what to say anymore. Oh man, so completely random, but I just found out that you can render trees in Photoshop now. So you can just go render tree. So if I go new layer, filter, render, tree. Pulls up this tree thing. So, I don't know. Maybe I don't even need a tree tutorial anymore. Let's do a cypress tree. And then you can just choose the light direction and stuff. How many leaves? And branch thickness and stuff. It's really strange. Yeah, isn't that weird? And now I can just... And so I was thinking about this, and it's actually kind of cool because you could just use this to concept with. You could just be like, oh, I'm going to throw these trees in here. So now you could take these trees, and I could like do a super sense of scale thing here and start. At first I thought it was dumb, but I think there's actually a little bit of a, you can actually kind of use it. So imagine just taking a few of these and just plop them around here and not even really thinking about them as like that useful on their own, but you know, render tree, so I can go back in here
and make another tree that's the same style of tree. And to like, let's see, change the leaves. I could put different leaves on it. It can be completely different. So now I could just take this and, where are cypress? Maybe want a spruce tree in there too. We'll do default leaves. Random shapes. Do another cypress one. And then, you know, you could take this and throw it in there again and have like a consistent lighting and stuff like that. And, you know, you might not use these as a final thing because, I mean, they look terrible, but at the same time, they're kind of cool. Yeah. Photoshop CC. But now, like, take that and you can start applying. Like, I could start building this into my world a little bit. I could take, you know, some atmosphere and just throw them across some of these. Really, oops. Just lightly. Maybe one's in the back. Flat it down. Take that speed tree. Now there's flat trees. I mean, yeah, exactly. Like it's really kind of cool, I think. But it's silly, but kind of cool. Yeah, you could do that too. I mean, but then it's not a new feature in Photoshop if you do that. I'm just kidding. Why can't I get my... There, go 100%. There we go. But yeah, you could just, you know, go like this and... It's all right. I could see it as being kind of useful. I'm just gonna flatten all this stuff. It's too many layers. I'm tired of working with all these layers. Would he be happy or would he be horrified? I mean, honestly, Bob Ross could paint a tree way faster than I just did using that render thing. I don't know if you've seen Bob Ross paint a tree, but he knows how to make a happy tree happy. He posted a 10-second tree tutorial where you render a tree. I'll do like a special tutorial and just release it to you only and be like, here you go, thanks, it's all yours. It's all yours. Yeah, and like even if you don't use it in your painting, you could use it as a reference. I know you could just search trees and stuff, but having them all kind of unified like that's kind of cool. I think it's pretty nifty. Speaking of trees, let's draw one. I don't know if I got your opinion on something I'm working on. Yeah, sure thing, knitted mittens. Send away. Can you send it to my Facebook channel? How do I pick up all your followers here? Magic. I don't know. I just stripteases. I don't know. Followers, ginger snaps. How did you find me? Striptease, yeah. Everyone's here for the striptease. But yeah, just send me a message on there, and I'll. You retweeted me. Thank you. No, I really.
I'm a little unsure how. Partially, I have it posting through ArtStream, so every time I stream, it shows up in the streams on ArtStation. Not ArtStream, sorry. ArtStation. So that has part of it. I'm sure it's a combination of things. You saw pumpkins? I mean, once you see pumpkins, you can't leave. Mainly, people come here to see me be an idiot. Oh, yeah. It all leads back to set. So yeah, ArtStation. I think ArtStation might be one of the more main ones. Because if you do a hashtag, a host, all sorts of different ways. If you do a hashtag on your stream, like you just do a hashtag ArtStation. I think it has to be. I don't know if it has to be the first hashtag in the post. But yeah, it'll propagate into the ArtStation stream. So that's pretty cool. What was I doing? Oh yeah. Let me know when you send that to me, and I'll check it out. Basically, I just stumbled onto, like, a really nice community of people. At least that's how I felt it happened. Low FPS. Yeah. I posted on Twitter and things like that. I said that I'd be streaming. So I've got, like, 1,000 Twitter followers, maybe? Cheating at trees. Don't you call me out on my trees. You love those trees, Pixel. Oh, what's that? What happened? Oh, Eric. That's how. Eric hosts my streams all the time, and I get a ton of streams from him. Wouldn't everyone be a better artist if they're a redhead? How's it going, everybody? It's a very organized raid, too. Oh, hey, thanks for the follow. FYAA. My screen is so tiny, why can't I can't see. There we go, then make it bigger. There we go. So many tears. How's it going, Eric? And everybody that came along with him, I appreciate you stopping by. Today's just a doodle stream. And ignore my choppy camera, it's broken. Yes, my last name is Polish, that's true. Tamakachu, thank you for the follow. Look at me move and chop around. Aw, thanks for the follow, Scratch. I appreciate it. Yeah. It's super, super choppy camera. Gustavink, thank you for the follow. Thank you, everybody. Ah, you're Polish too? Hello, I'm Serious. Thank you for the follow. I really appreciate it. You did a landscape today? I'm having a rough day today, so I wouldn't count on it. Chilberin, thank you. Yeah, sorry about the cam. But yeah, Yeah, I'm Polish. I've never been to the motherland, but I'm very proud of my heritage and everything. Thank you for this follow, Yolor. Do people prefer a stream where you ask questions or condensed video of working on something? Insane Orpid. Thank you for the follow. I would say a lot of people, I asked a lot of questions early on, and a lot of people told me kind of just to make the stream what you want to do. And that's kind of what I ended up doing, just sort of, it evolved as I was going along with it. It didn't really have a particular format or anything like that. I watched a few other streams. I don't know if mine's anything like them or whatnot, but Eric Paints actually super helped me get going in the beginning. And a bunch of others had lots of suggestions and things like that. So it was really nice. It was, I was just amazed how nice all the community has been, which is super great. Everyone's been so kind. I think I've only ever had one person kind of troll the stream, maybe once. Aww, thanks for the host. I appreciate it. Well, obviously I need to get a webcam because mine is crap. It's not doing so good. Eric Paints is such a nice guy. Wah! There we go. Cool! 777, thank you for the follow. Overwatch later? Yeah, we can play some Overwatch later. That sounds like fun. Yeah, it's just a doodle stream today, so hopefully it's not a letdown for everybody. Just kind of exploring some colors and stuff. Yeah, Bangs. Yeah, why not? Thanks, Eric. I appreciate it. Thanks for stopping by. Thanks for all the follows, or all the hostings you've done. I'm just kind of all over the place for drawing today. Bye, Eric! Thank you! Just trying to figure out some compositions and stuff. This is all just doodling. Doodly doodles. I was thinking about doing some combinations of like a doodle, like sketching in 3D and stuff. That might be kind of interesting. I'm going to work on this composition a little bit more, and then I'm going to add color on top of it. A little rusty. I haven't actually painted any environments in about a week. Been mainly painting props and stuff at work. And also, I was on vacation for a little while. Oh, did I paint this all in the same layer? Oh, dang it, I did. Blurp. Let me just cut that out. Next stream with 3D coat. How about you do a few streams like that, and then you can teach me. Yeah, I'm just kind of trying to get a sense of form and things like here. Starting out with a really base silhouette things. And I'm just playing around with shifting hues and things like that. Maybe I'll go into kind of these warmer colors. Actually, you know, I kind of want to do a community choice on what to make them go ham bone. Brown, 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 brown. Yeah. Scratch, I can help you set up all the required streaming tools and such. I'm gonna do quick sky again behind. Whoops. Make a new layer again. Aw, thank you, Gustavink. I appreciate it. I'm gonna be a little honest today. I'm a little bit in a, not like an art funk, but just kind of a little rusty and things like that, so. I appreciate it. Thank you. Thank you. I appreciate it. Very kind. But yeah, Scratch, you should totally get your stream going. It's never too early to start. Just kind of pulling the shapes out here a little bit by little bit. Kind of. Yeah, I probably could actually do this a little faster if I just throw a layer on top of here. And I'm going to cut this layer out, paste it up top. Yeah, it's starting to feel better. I'm just kind of. I'm going to just kind of pull in some gradients here. And then keep pushing the lighting a little bit more and just slowly get into a little bit some different colors. I want to go a little yellow and a little bit more gray too. And I have an idea for this one that I kind of want to push with. I just have to kind of get it to that point. So now that I have that gradient on there. Okay, cool. Yeah, well, I can't wait to see it, Nate. Now that I have that on there, I'm just going to pull some kind of tree forms, kind of the texture you would see on the surface of the tree, just to kind of pull out the shapes and things like that. Finish him. I mean, your portfolio. And once you have stuff like this, you can start putting little highlights and things just to kind of saturate it a little bit off it, but. Yeah, just little bits where you pull it out. Yeah, a little bit of texture here and there. And I was thinking that this, let's take a look at this. Is the top image the old one? Cool. I might, like in this one here, it seems like you have like a, this, like maybe you need a more generic grass texture going throughout these. See how like these main little turfs of grass here? Maybe have a more generic grass throughout and then have some of those be more bigger textures within it. But house looks really cool. I'd like to see a few smaller details in the house, perhaps, just to give it like kind of more of a focal point. Like it's definitely a focal point with the lighting and stuff, but yeah. Really nice textures and everything. Oh, are these the only the few pieces you used? Cool, nice textures. And some of the spots in these textures here, like you have really nice patterns and stuff, but you might want to lower the contrast a little bit. So it's sort of, sort of reads a little bit better, because if the higher contrast you have in a texture, the more like you'll start noticing repeating patterns right away.
So just try to avoid that. But really good work overall. Did my stream stop working? Let me check. Twitch. Let me see if it's still working on my end. Working fine for you? Looks like it's working. Yeah, it's still working for me. Like you have focal points here, but use some of your environment things as that as well. Like these flowers and stuff could be used as kind of a way to bring the path, lead the player, and things like that. If there is a player. Texture looking really good here. You might need more of a generic texture for your overall rock that you're using repeatedly over here. If you reference, like, it might not be apply the same style, but the guys and gals at Unreal are really good at doing that. I love the little floaty bits and the coloring, lighting, and things like that. I'd probably drop out that first image, it's just so dark. Yeah, that's super cool. Did that stuff help at all? It was. I'm gonna jump back here. I want this to be in a desert. This. Yeah, I can give you some more extensive feedback if you want. Let me know if you want that. If not, but yeah, just tone down the contrast in a few of your textures. A good example of if you look at like textures that have to be used repeatedly a ton, a pretty good example of that actually is Mario Galaxies. You can find texture rips of their stuff, and it actually helped me a lot when I was learning how to texture. Hey! Iloafra! I don't know how to say that, but thank you for the follow. Thanks for joining us. You know what I don't ask that I should probably ask more? Where's everybody from? I'm always curious about that. Aaron King, welcome. Thanks for the follow. Welcome to the stream. I really appreciate everybody stopping by. That was pretty awesome. Got a bunch of new people today. Where's everybody hail from? Oregon, nice. Ah, right behind you. That's a good answer. I love more feedback. I'm trying to send out apps tomorrow. Belgium, nice. Oh man, everybody's from everywhere. Ecuador. Hey, I have a friend that lives in Ecuador. It's Digital Rain. Italy and Tennessee. Oh man, this is like all across the spectrum. That's awesome. Well. Defina. Thank you for the follow. Welcome to the stream. Oh. Barcelona. Jenny Shee. Thank you for the follow. Welcome. Oh, everybody's. So many follows today. It's so cool.
And just to think, I almost didn't stream today because of camera issues and things. But I guess luckily I did. I'm gonna use like a little bit of a texture brush or something. I haven't really. Oh, I don't really like that one. Let's try this one. Yeah, it's more fitting for this. Let's throw a little texture in here. I'm actually gonna go back to that's the older tree. This one, and I wanna change the silhouette a little bit. There's some parts that are bugging me. I wish I could visit all of those places. I've only been to Canada. Well, I've been to a bunch of other places in the United States, but a bunch of other states, but no other countries other than Canada. But yeah. I was thinking of, let's see. I've got this sand over here. Maybe we'll put some little rocks and things in here. Yeah. Also, they just redid the floors and they used a bunch of glue, and the glue was giving me a headache, but. Pushed through it. Ignored that. Let's see, now I want to do a little bit of maybe some just some simple clouds back here. Oops. Just a little something back here. Trying to use out the basic circle brush a little bit more. I don't know if it's good. I just haven't really used it that much. Let me put another layer, and this one's going to be just like a soft light. And I just want to bring out the lighting in this a little bit better. That should be good. One thing that's really missing from this piece right now, though, is like some sort of sense of scale, and it's kind of missing like the extra layer of depth that it could have. So let's do that. So I'm just gonna grab this color of kind of unlit, and I'm just stroking across here, and figure out my different distances. And now I can paint that as crossed. Now it's like a distance. You have kind of that far background. Maybe another one that's a little bit darker. Midground. Maybe we could just actually kind of. I'll just grab it with the lasso tool. Boop, boop. Put it to a gradient. Just, oh, I've got a radial gradient. I want a linear. Scale birds incoming. Shush. Could be anything incoming. It doesn't have to be scaled, or you never know. Let's see. The rest of these are kind of butts. Oops, I took too many layers away. Just gonna turn these off and redo them. Wandering Stick Salesman. Should we do that? Should we do the Wandering Stick Salesman? Any teeps?
baking gift things would be handy when it comes to color palettes?
I think really simple. Don't overthink it. I think a lot of people get too in-depth with their color, and it just ends up looking like chaos. Just be... There's the wandering stick man. I'll pull up the color wheel and just keep it really basic. I don't really do anything too complicated, usually complementary colors, or I'll take like real world colors and sort of apply those in. Give him a shield, a stick. This guy's looking like a butt. It's bird time. Birds. another tip you can do is say go to like let's go to like a website with landscapes or something. So like a Tumblr, and just scroll through and say you find a color or like a nice colored, like this one's really cool and this one's really cool. So we could take these and use them as inspiration. I really like this one too. So you could just take this, let's open down a new image. Let's go back up to this one as well. I'm just gonna copy this, and then what I'll do, I'll just throw this in here, and instead of leaving it as a current photo as it is, I'll go up to filter, pixelate, mosaic, and then kind of toy with that a little bit. And now we've got some basic colors to work with. We've got some nice blues and purples and things like that. So you could just kind of play with these colors to come up with a color scheme of your own. It's a good way to kind of get away from the original photo or whatever that you're looking at. And then you could just take that. Yeah, the URL. So you could just take that and let's say it's right here. And then, hey Seth, how's it going? I mean, there's like the sky color or something like that. Yeah, mosaic filter. And then that'll give you a good start for colors. But usually I'll just go also just pull up a color wheel. Just any old color wheel. Oh, it's fine. I had a lot of technical difficulties. And I'll just, you know, I'm working with blue here, so another nice color will be yellow. So let's do complementary colors for these oranges and things like that. So yeah. That's another way I'll approach it. Trying to think of any other color tips. The big one is just really just keep it simple. Don't overthink it. Oh, what just happened? Oh, thank you. Thank you so much for the donation. I really appreciate that, Jenny. Thank you so much. That's too kind. Too kind. So, thank you. Kind of reminds me somewhat of a world tree in a decayed land. Yeah, I need to work on the scale a little bit more on that one. If I put a person in there, that would help. I usually put stairs or something like that. I'm just gonna, like, in my mind, I have kind of a sense of what the scales look like, so I'm actually gonna go and just... I kind of want to do another tree or something. I still don't really have a good idea of what I want to do. Perhaps I will do some kind of blue-gray mountains or something like that. So let's paint some mountains in here. So we're gonna just go along
back here. And maybe this time, instead of, you know, using a bunch of colors and a bunch of layers, let's just paint the background in right off the bat. And I'm using just the same color, and it's just kind of this gray-blue color. So, and we're just gonna place some stuff off in the distance, perhaps. Or maybe we'll skip that for now and just go a little, grab this a little darker. Just have this kind of valley sloping into the center here. Sloping off this. I'm just going to ignore all this edge stuff. I don't really care about that right now. I'm going to go a little desaturated. I'm going to paint in some mountains or something. Ooh, hanging city from a giant tree sounds pretty cool. I'll paint these in darker. I want to make a world tree, be pretty low, a normal sized tree on a hill. That's kind of cool. I like, oh, everyone's come up with great ideas and I have none today. Sometimes that happens. Do you critique works? Link something, quick look. Yeah, I check out works. It depends if I'm working on a piece or not. Like right now, I'm just kind of hanging out, hanging with everybody, talking and stuff. So yeah, send me what you're working on. I'd love to see it. And I'll give you a critique on it. I am pretty directly honest with my critiques, so... I don't sugarcoat it. So if that's okay, then send away. I'm gonna use a square one again. Because when I critique, I'm not. I think, sure, everyone knows this, but when you're getting a critique, it's not like the person is trying to tear down the person that did it. It's just honestly, it's like another. It's people seeing it before it's even passed on, so it's really great to have the opportunity that someone can check it out before it's been passed on. Joel, thank you for the follow. I really appreciate it. Hey, Zoologico, how's it going? Welcome back. Pour some sugar on me. But yeah, you know, you gotta... it's if you can have someone look at your work before, you know, whoever you really want to take a look at your work, then that's ideal always. You heading out, Shrill Llama? Well, thanks for joining us though. Yeah, as of late, I've actually been doing most of my... I'll do, like, a bunch of thumbnails. Just line work, and then I turn those into 3D and kind of back and forth mixing. And things like that. So, I think I need to work on my... just straight-to-color work. Kind of come up with a bit better, a little faster workflow perhaps. We're not going an IP redesign, but I only have one set of characters, so that's done so far. Oh, cool. Change your rumor background has been dark. There was never a door there. Forever there was never a door. Yeah, I'm in a different room. I'm in the opposite room. I'm in the opposite room that I was in. And yeah, it's hopefully gonna be my new studio room. I used to have a roommate that lived in this room, and he moved on, got some different work and things like that. And so I hadn't set it up in a long time. It was just kind of empty and hadn't been cleaned out. Well, it wasn't empty. No, it was full of stuff, and there was no room to even do anything in there. So, not his stuff, just stuff that I tossed in there. Jenny Sheesh! Such a great artist, finally able to catch you. Oh, thank you. I appreciate it. Well, I'm glad you're able to catch me live. I need to... Hopefully I can stream more. It really depends how things are going with work and stuff. So, and I like to at least try to guarantee the one Thursday stream. But I know we've, you know, I've got lots of different time zones and stuff, so it's really hard for everybody to reach that time. But I wish I could. I wish I could stream more often. Oh, back to the color question that you had that was being asked earlier. Notice how this is all pretty much monochromatic. It's really just some different shifts and blues and things like that. And now that I have that, I can take this and, like, I'm sort of just thinking of it almost in one single color. And now I'm going to start bringing in a few other colors. Like, I can think, you know, I've got a little bit of that blue sky kind of deflecting down and hitting inside here. So we're just going to plop a little bit of color in here, just to get some color variation too. But you notice too, I'm starting to kind of draw on the ground, sort of patternings and things like that. I'm sort of just drawing out how these shapes will work, and kind of how the ground plane will work and things like that. Thinking about paths and areas where water has flowed down on the ground and kind of broken it apart and things like that. So once I have like that kind of that base, really this is just a background, a mid-ground piece, and now I'm just going to grab another layer on top here, and this is, we're just going to throw some grass down and choose kind of a nice grass color. I'm going to go with kind of more of a yellowy color, and I don't know if that really, let's look what we're doing. So we did blue, we've got all this blue color, so complementarily is yellow, and you can kind of fudge it and kind of slide over, you know, this way on the wheel, and yellow, green, so. And let me just slide it here, and I've got this on a new layer, and now I can start just dragging that in. Let me try a different brush again. Yeah, this brush is kind of cool. And I can drag this in a little bit and then go through and sort of cut areas out of it. Maybe I'll use my old texture brush that I normally use. No, with this one I just did straight color. Trying to remember, there was a girl that was doing a bunch of thumbnails online, and it kind of inspired me to get back into doing straight color thumbnails, because I used to do it long ago, but kind of stopped for a while. So I'm just pulling in some different grass colors and things like that. I'm kind of thinking this is sort of the in shadow color of grass, or this is sort of the in lighting area, and kind of blend those two together and just overlay them as I go. There's actually a brush I used to use all the time, and I can't find it. I don't know which one it is. I lost it. Aw. Thanks, Seth. I feel like I'm just kind of struggling with it, but if it looks good, I appreciate it. Yeah, I'm going back to my old brush. Classic brush, and then you can just kind of go in here, and since I have in a different layer, I can come back in and cut it out, add some extra texture and detail and things like that, and sort of explore the way this is on this mountain and things like this, or on these rocks. Maybe it's overgrowing them, maybe it's just kind of just whatever. Maybe I watched too much Bob Ross. I'm like totally channeling Bob Ross. I'm like, yeah, whatever it is. There's no accidents. Everything's just a happy mistake. And I'm thinking about clouds kind of casting over and casting large shadows in these areas, so it's not too open. Like if you have a large area of openness, just pretend there's a shadow or a cloud going across it, and you can break it up, and that can be a compositional element. Or there's like an off-screen object casting over it, like a giant mountain or something. And I think I learned that from, I was watching Feng Zhu's videos a long time ago, and he kind of does that, or he talked about it, or mentioned it once, or I interpreted that, I don't remember. Yeah, so we're starting to get a lot more color and stuff. I'm trying to stay zoomed out. I might erase some more just to kind of pull in some of this previous color. Yeah, Feng Zhu, I think, was working on some MMO drawings for MMO. He was talking about breaking up large areas with shadows casting across them and things like that. But yeah, I'm a little rusty on the whole thumbnailing color. And if you need to push something back like this, you can just grab the blue area or color or something like that and just kind of push it back with some solid blue. If you have atmosphere in your painting. But in this, I might actually paint it a little darker than I need to and then bring it back. I should stay zoomed out a bit more. Pepperidge Farm remembers. Oh, something happened. Sirloin the Third. Hey, thanks for following. I see other landscape artists do grayscale first. I don't always do this. I'm a little rusty at it. Normally I do, like I was saying, line art first. But yeah, I wanna get a little bit better at this again. Yes, Sirloin, how's it going? I'm actually gonna paint this a little darker back here, and I'm gonna do an overlay layer and fix it up.
Like to see the finished product if it's good.
Oh yeah, yeah. Everyone should. You should post that. I'm a little darker in this. You'll see why. See why in a second. It'll make sense. It'll all make sense, hopefully. Unless I mess it up. So I'm just gonna do this really simply. Have the lighting come across here. This is here. And basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to use atmospheric stuff instead of trying to paint it at the right values and things like that in the distance. I'm just going to go in. Paint some areas, maybe try adding a few more highlights and things like that, just little scribbles. I was gonna try it, let's see if this works. I wanted to try these. Yeah, early stages, of course. Well, let's check it out. Okie dokie.
Only thing I'm worried about a little bit here, I'll just pull it into Photoshop really quick. And do a new canvas. So the first thing, my first concern with this one would be is your value structure. Whoops. How did I do that? Oh, there we go. It's not really a clear distinction between foreground and background. So let me put a new layer on top here. So maybe a clearer distinction between these elements and these elements and things like that. See how these, like this, these things here are kind of blending together. The other thing too is everything's kind of pushed to the left and right in the composition. Like this isn't a good compositional point, but you might want to incorporate some of these objects further into the ground. And like this one, you have it kind of split right down the center. Maybe this is kind of growing over a little bit more. So you have sort of a piece here, and then you can have your path sort of leading in like this. Let's see. And then you can have your foreground element here. I'm just worried that you have all these objects over to the side too much. And yeah, so work on the composition a little bit. Try not to have things, you know, crunched over to the side like this. They feel almost too much like an artificial frame. So try to push away from that a little bit. And then let's go back to the color. The color one, you know, I can kind of see that you did sort of like a color overlay thing here. And I would work on coming up with like an idea of a distinct atmosphere. So if the color of the sky is kind of blue purple, that'd kind of be fading across into the rest of the area. You know, you'd probably have that start like applying into here more and kind of affecting all this lighting. And the colors here, it's a little too, I'm unsure what the lighting color is and what the atmosphere color is, but there's some cool colors that you might want to focus on a few less colors to start with. Because you kind of have a lot of them over in here. You got purples, greens, blues, greens, greens, and blues, kind of jump back and forth. So sort of simplify it. And yeah. I really like kind of the environment and the world you're building here. I want to see these things that you have way off in the distance here. These are some of the most interesting shapes right here, but you have them hidden way in the background. Oops, I gotta put my flow. So bring some of these guys, maybe put them in the mid-ground here, and then like far over here. Maybe there's one of these things like right here or something. One of those objects. Yeah. Let me know if that helped. Not. I don't know. But yeah, I just focus on working on the composition first. I kind of feel like doodling. I might doodle some. Just some simple doodles. Okay, cool. I'm glad you like the tips. Just remember to keep it simple. And definitely look at a color wheel. I think some of your color is a little too brash almost. How do I go about having my values better for the foreground, middle ground, background? Study value structures of pictures you find and photos and things like that. But normally foreground, well here I'll do a super, I'll go back to this and I'll do a quick value study here. So we'll start with this kind of base color here. I'll throw some clouds down because I love my clouds. And then, you know, as we come forward,
it gets a little darker. So we've got this background here, and maybe there's these little rocks and things like that. And then another layer forward would be a little bit more, a little darker. Some more rocks and things like that as well. And then we can start thinking about lighting and kind of things like that. But as you get closer and closer to the camera, unless there's lighting things involved, things will be tend to be darker. And also, yeah, I think for a value structure, you want to make sure that you have a good value range, a good lights and darks. But yeah, definitely, you know, have a good value range of things. I usually kind of just work from light to dark, and if I'm working in black and white, just kind of keep pushing things like this. Yeah.
Roll, squiggle, squiggles.
Yeah, I think I'm going to do a little just black and white doodling. I haven't had really any good ideas today. Let's go a little smaller on the brush here. Do another tree for fun. Maybe this tree has like these growths on it or something. This isn't my normal drawing brush, is it? I'm trying to find this. This is my normal drawing brush. Yeah, I'll do the wrong. Felt weird. I'm thinking compositionally, maybe I will throw a little person in here. I love me some capes. Just a little doodle here. It looked like someone was about to draw Old West or something. Little sense of scale. And now I'm just kind of figuring out where kind of the ground might curve and appear. I'm just pulling off some other branches. What's your settings for your sketch brush? The one I'm using, sketch, feels really clunky. Let's see. I think it's a square, and I've got like pen pressure turned on, some color dynamics with a tiny bit of hue jitter, transfers checked, and smoothing. And then I also make sure that the spacing is all the way down. It looks like it's just like a rectangle. Yeah. It's really basic stuff. I'll use that or like a circle brush or something like that. Oh, Bob Ross. What a wonderful person. Kind of think like maybe the ground's cut in a little bit here, and then I want this branch right here to kind of pull forward.
tapers across here.
Relaxing.
Yeah, rain is nice. I'm sorry, just exploring the phone. Is that the Sun and Moon Pokemon game coming out? I'm gonna have that tree kind of, this branch kind of bend away. I was talking to my nephew, and he was really into Pokemon. And I don't know, maybe I should give it a go. I haven't had much time to play video games though lately. Though I did pop in No One Lives Forever, which I don't know if anyone's played that, but it's a fantastic game. I was playing on the PS2. I originally, back in the day, I'd played it on the Back in the day, I'd played it on the PC, but having it on PS2 is kind of nice because you can kind of plop it in whenever. But is that the main focus of Pokemon Snaps? Because that's my favorite part, is that it's the main focus of those games. I actually did play Pokemon Snap like last week. I gotta catch them all. Ah, cool! Yeah, let's sketch together. I love when people sketch at the same time. Just having a community of people arting is really cool. I wish I lived next to some people that drew. Or I guess, I can't say that that's not the case. I know there's an animation studio that's pretty close by, and they probably draw quite a bit. Pokemon, catch 'em all. Why is my eraser not? Seems like it's not erasing very well. It's like I have to press super hard. It's annoying. Overrated. That's true. Well, I played the demo. Is there a demo on the 3DS store? Or the... No, that's racing. Excuse me, much better. Well, I'll have to try that when my girlfriend returns, because I'm awesome and she's traveling. I let her take my 3DS. So she's been playing Mario Kart 7 a lot on it. That's like, oh, can't not let you play that. Seeing Other Humans 2016. Eh, there we go. I do end up seeing a lot of other humans. But, I don't know. Okay, I'll talk to you later, Scratch. Let me know how this, get the stream going. I'd like to see that, see you get working on that. Do it!
Now you don't have a girlfriend anymore. You have someone who plays Animal Crossing now. No, just kidding. Oh, Scratch is a super nice dude. I think I've been just in a more of a drawing mood lately, I guess. Something about filling the world in this way has been easier for me lately. I don't know what it is. It's probably just because I've been practicing it more lately. Brush question. Though that link might be broken. Oh no. It's not. Yay. Oof. I thought it was broken, but it's not. That's good. What was I gonna do? I don't know, my eye just started twitching for no reason. Exactly, yay, not broken brushes. That Harry Potter movie come out soon? The mystical, magical beast? I want to go see that. And then there's that new trailer for that it was just called Kong, I think, or something. That looked pretty cool too. Had a strange cast, but like in a good way. It was like John Goodman, John C. Reilly, Samuel L. Jackson. Looked pretty cool. Yeah, I'm normally that way, but I'm a pretty big Harry Potter nerd. Those books had a huge impact on my life, I guess, I think. Oh, it's out now? Oh, wow. Well. I'll have to go watch that. Well, my girlfriend gets back. She would destroy me if I watched it without her. Ooh, Doctor Strange. I already watched that. I loved it, actually. Was I 11 before they came out? I think I was about the right age for them when they started coming out. I do remember, like, reading them, and then when the book was over, just being kind of almost heartbroken that I knew that magic wasn't real, and I just wished it was. But yeah. Yeah, Doctor Strange was really good. I'm not a huge Marvel fan. I can't remember if I talked about this on stream or not, but I liked
Guardians of the Galaxy a ton and didn't even know it was part of the Marvel Universe until much later. And part of me was kind of disappointed that it was. And, but yeah. Like, I mean, I like the movies, alright. I just... Oh. Yeah. Much more into, like, Lord of the Rings and things like that. But Guardians of the Galaxy was amazing, and I felt like the only movie that's come close to that as far as Marvel movies have been is Doctor Strange, and I love Doctor Strange, so it's my number two Marvel movie. Yeah. Yeah, it's a character. I draw this character a lot. It's kind of like my default character. It's like my version of the Stick Man. But it's like Stick Lady. I actually have the character. Let me see if I can. My photo. I don't think it really nails the whole hair though. Yeah, it does. It's really engrossing. Even as an adult, I'm just like, oh my gosh, I wish that was me. Here's that character again. I guess I sort of. Actually, thought Strange was way more real crazy than. Cool. CK Havoc, thank you for the follow. Don't know if it was hype, but actually thought Strange was way more visually crazy than what it was. It was super crazy visual. I loved it. Tim, how do you make a normal dumb character, a normal dumb human character interesting? Get a stick. Something asymmetrical, usually. Yeah, a good hairstyle. Strong pose, which I'm not the best at. You could have this like a stick figure, and if it has a pose that really determines like the mood, if you can get a mood across using pose, then yeah. Focus details up in the face area. Don't get too crazy with. Well, I see a lot of people do characters and they like over detail the legs and things. And no one's gonna look at the legs. Everyone looks at the face. In the past, when I designed characters, I would do silhouettes first. I have a strong silhouette read. Hey, thanks, Havoc. I appreciate it. Just kind of a doodle stream today. Well, I did some color stuff, but we moved on from that. What time is it? Oh, it's 8:45. I'm gonna do another sketch. Because that was a lot of fun. And maybe next week it'll be a real stream. We're just gonna start out with this shape. And then the ground plane here. And then little rocks here. That's what I'm working on. Thinking of 12 cells. Normal dude TM. Did you say some comic stuff? We were talking about Doctor Strange and Harry Potter. Oh, I did pick up a comic. I haven't read it yet. It's called Snot Girl. And the girl on the cover looks just like my girlfriend. Well, not like it just looks like an anime interpretation or a comic. It's kind of an anime-ish looking cartoon. So like an interpretation of her. She has like bright green hair and she's wearing like a pink fluffy jacket. My girlfriend was literally just wearing that the other day. And she has bright green hair as well now.
Seems like her hair color changes more than the seasons. Which is cool.
Oh, draw a circle. Come on, dang it. Yeah, whatever.
Trying to start my graphic novel, but don't have much experience trying to bring storyboarding experience into it.
Oh, yeah. Actually, I did a little graphic novel a long time ago. If I have it. But that just reminded me. I don't know if I posted it yet, but. So I found the first painting I ever did. And does everybody want to see it? Also, unrelated, Seth drew this last week. So, it's pretty awesome. It's kimchi. It's a T-Rex. Oh, but anyways, so... Yeah, I found even more old old art. So this was from 1993. I might be able to see if I can pull up even more. Let's see if I can pull this up. So, yeah, okay, here it is. So this painting here, it's drawn on a piece of cardboard, and the cardboard is from like the cereal. It's from this big, my mom used to get bulk puffed wheat. So it's from a cardboard box of puffed wheat, and this is framed on their wall. I was younger than 10. I was maybe like... Oh, this is requiring math. 84 is when I was born, so... Six. I guess I was like 8 or 9. The Eagles are coming. Those are classic W's. So, I did that, and then... I don't... Yeah, exactly. It's like graphite, oil, and acrylic. The funniest part is we're going to jump ahead to 2007, and I got really bad. Like, I literally got worse. These are my first digital paintings I could find. I might have some older ones, but these are from, yeah, 2007. Yeah, that is rainy mood. It's always a moody, rainy time. See, I did these in, puff wheat paintings are the best. But, so this was a long time later, and I feel like my painting when I was a little kid was a lot better. But, look at this. This is, something. I remember thinking this one was my favorite one here. I was like, oh, this is gonna get me jobs and stuff. I literally just like drew circles and repeated it. But yeah. I feel like this was much better. Look, I even use some silver paint for a few highlights for the metal. Yeah, it was mainly the media shift. It's pretty rough. It's pretty rough. But, yeah, it's pretty cool. It was fun. Yeah, it was definitely just switching media. And also, I feel like when you're going and learning new stuff, you kind of almost... tend to shift backwards a little bit until you get better. Like learning art, you sort of sometimes you just go backwards. At least that's how it was for me. You get worse before you get better.
hard to make digital work in a money mess.
Yeah, that's for sure. But yeah, I always like to, if I'm showing people, I did like a presentation, I showed some people some of my work, and I was like, you know, I'll show them what my work used to look like. Because it was pretty bad. I'm going to put that in later. I think of like how to shape this rock. Yeah, it's a frustrating time, but I think it's worth it. So, and then the other frustrating part is when you go back to traditional, if you've been doing digital for a long time, you kind of have the same, at least for me, like it's sort of same thing. Like I had a significant learning curve when I did my Inktober this year, but that was also really cool too, the doing Inktober. I need to do some more ink stuff. I had a lot of fun doing that. Yeah, before that I couldn't find them. I had drawings before that. I drew birds all the time. And actually, I have an interview. I'm doing an interview for, was it 2D Art Magazine? And one of the questions they asked is like something about how you started your music. I don't know, something about getting started in art. And when I was a kid, I drew birds all the time. All the time. Like it was just birds after birds. And there was no like landscape environment or anything. But yeah, it does seem like environments have always kind of been my cup of tea, even though for a long time I didn't really realize it. There's just something about my like crafting worlds and such. But yeah, I feel like that's an encouraging thing to show artists. The rain was, that question has three answers. First answer, when I first started streaming, I wanted to be able to have the streams up for people to watch that missed them and things like that. And also, you know, if I wanted to take them and turn them into like speed paints or something like that. I wanted to be able to keep them around a bit easier. And when I played music, they would get slapped with copyright issues. I was like, oops, it's lame. I'll be able to keep them up. And I started for a while, I played like non-copyright music and things like that, but I wasn't a huge fan of the music and I felt like it didn't really fit my stream and encapsulate what I wanted in my stream. And also I didn't like going through and having to focus on the music and think about the music. I wanted to focus on more of the art stuff. And I had some people suggest the rain, you know, like audio just kind of in the background. I was like, yeah, that's perfect. And so I started playing that. Pretty much haven't stopped ever since. I did have, like sometimes I'll play more appropriate music to a scene. One of my friends will get on stream and be like, hey, you should play some desert music and not rain since you're painting a desert scene. So I might, you know, have some sandstorm type stuff kind of whistling and wind whistling and things like that. So yeah, that's those are the reasonings. Hey, Timbit123, thanks for the follow. Appreciate it. It's not even booting up. Yep, so that's the story of how I started listening to Rain in my stream. Listen to very relaxing music in the rain. Nice. Yeah, I think it's a little less distracting than music sometimes. Try doing a Control-Alt-Delete and like canceling out anything that has like the Adobe stuff on it, maybe? Maybe there's like something else going on in there. That sounds strange. Okay, see you in a bit. Yeah. Oh. Fifth or sixth or seventh time's the charm. You fall asleep. I'm sure my monotone voice isn't helping. Blah 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 blah. It's too relaxing. I have to scream really loudly once in a while to wake people up. Turn it into an ASMR stream.
Yeah, we're gonna just start drawing some small rocks up here in the distance. Let's just listen to the pen as it scratches across the surface.
I was thinking maybe one or two more sketches. I don't really know. I haven't decided. I usually just draw till I get tired. Or unless I have other things I have to do. Which I was probably gonna draw until I go play Overwatch. I posted a YouTube video and someone's like, "You're so quiet, it's like an ASMR," and I was like, "Yeah, it kind of is." But yeah, just become an ASMR stream. Might actually go grab something to drink really quick, because I am thirsty. I'll be right back. Kimchi, entertain them. Oh no, he won't stay. Mark, mark. I know it's laggy, but there's kimchi. Everybody's got a cat.
The real kimchi.
Some ASMR purring. Okay, I'll stop bothering you, kimchi.
Thanks for hanging out. You just gonna stay? Okay.
Yep, he's a Maine Coon, or at least part Maine Coon. He is the fluffiest. He's a rescue, so we're not exactly sure what he is, but pretty sure he's got a bunch of Maine Coon in him. He's a really sweet cat, though. He's just hanging out next to me now. He's so laid back. I can't imagine getting a better cat than him. Yeah. How much does your Maine Coon weigh? Or how long is he about? Yeah, he's got like the little tufts in his ears. And he's got like the little fluffy feet and stuff too. Yeah, so Tomlin's huge, so he's probably part Maine Coon as well. I don't know if 20 pounds.
I don't know, kimchi. Kimchi's like
probably 15 or 20. Maybe just 15. I don't really know.
What's up, kimchi?
Oh, he left us. He had other cat things to do. .10 He's getting up there. Oh, Kimchi's like 4 or 5 years old. That's like, I've heard stories of people buying, like, they get little, what is it, they buy pigs thinking they'll be those little potbelly pigs, the little tiny ones, and they're just normal-sized pigs, people selling them, and then they just get massive. Like, well, I guess you got a giant pig now. Yeah. I mean, the little ones, like the mini ones you can get there, I mean, like 5 or 10 pounds or something like that. Those little tiny guys. But people are just selling them normal pigs. I want to see your cat. Or a bunch of crazy cat people. Once you become a crazy cat person, you want to see everybody's cat. it work? Did it post?
Why don't I see it?
Let me load up just regular Twitch. Oh, this is a very cute cat. What's your cat's name? Empty cat. Gotta draw for a second there. I'm trying to draw a box. I couldn't even draw a box in perspective for a moment there. A boxer. The suspense. What's his name? Or her name? Smullen. A Swedish word for crumbs. Kimchi had a different name when we got him as well. Should we have everybody guess what his name was before it was Kimchi? Oops, I always type that wrong. Gamble. Shmulon? Equally lame. Fluffy butt. Yeah, that sounds like a cute name. However it's pronounced. His name was Kimchi. Oh no, his name wasn't Kimchi. His name was Carson. Oh, like the Dakota. Oh. Aww. Tomlin, what you doing? T-Dog. But yeah, his name was Carson. And we're just like, nah. It's too much of like a human sounding name or something. Makes me think of Carson Daly or something. I'm like, oh. No offense to anyone named Carson out there. I know, right? Isn't it a weird name? Hey Carson. Yeah. He doesn't recognize that name anymore. It's like that was a different world. I was a different cat then. Kimchi. Does anyone else's cat play fetch? Because Kimchi plays fetch. Plays a fetching game of fetch. They said he was 4. And they also said that he was probably like a stray or something. His ears have like little notches of ear missing from them. Check your up here at the top here. Or also check your brush dynamics and such. But yeah, he had like, he wasn't nearly as fluffy either. He was like missing a lot of hair and things like that. So he's doing much better than he was when we first got him.
Skimmer.
He's got a good life now. He's spoiled and eats too much. He gets cuddled whether he likes it or not. I wish I could have his life. I guess maybe I get a little bit bored, but to be owned by a crazy cat person would be the life. My girlfriend calls cat for a crazy lady litter. It's like, I'm covered in crazy lady glitter. Or something like that along those lines. It's kind of the perfect term. It does. It seems like he only really sheds a ton when he's stressed. Which, all the floors going in, he was stressed. I forgot to talk for a little bit there. And again. Maybe I'm getting sleepy. I'm
maybe it's a break time from the drawings. That is a really good picture of your cat. Yeah, Kimchi can look pretty grumpy too. Oh, that picture's really good. That's such a good picture. Go back to whence you came. That's so good. Still cute, though. Oh, weird, we have the same cat. Yeah, I like bugging Kimchi a lot. The more I bug him, though, the less he, like, reacts to it, though, so. Which is good, I suppose, but, you know. Don't bring up X-Files. Oh no. Real rain plus fake rain. Shouldn't those like cancel each other out though? Illuminati! Never forget. Never forgive. X-Files theme. Oh, I'm sorry, was it too loud? I tried whistling extra quiet, but I guess that's something that doesn't really happen.
What if I do la 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 la?
Oh, the real deal. Yeah.
just never get the, as long as we don't have the real deal, then there's no issue. Oh man, you're having lots of tablet issues. Okay. See ya, T-Dog. I never actually noticed that it was Timmy T-Dog. I just read it as Timmy T. I don't know if I ever made sure I'd done that. I must have noticed that. Like this was really boring, so I wanted to kind of change it up a little bit. Bring in some other elements that might make it a little more interesting. Pixel Bang, are you still around? Are you still there? Welcome back, that was fast. Wait, did you restart already? Crazy. I guess modern PCs. All that shtiff. Boot up really fast nowadays. Still used to my old Pentium 3. Oh, I was just seeing if you're still around. No, I didn't miss anything.
Nothing at all.
I don't know why I just said it like that. Oh, yeah. It would be rough. It'd be super rough. I almost whistled that theme song again. I take that and combine it with going back to like 56K or dial-up or something. Now that is real torture. If hell is real, that is it. Oh, that'd be kind of cool, like they kind of built their houses around these rocks because they give off energy and stuff. It's a baking sauna. old Viking sauna. When I was a kid, we used to use the Viking sauna to get all of our heat. Why was Morgan Freeman? Nearly. Oh no, what happened to my pen pressure? Oh, that's back. The only accent I can consistently do is say, in Michael Caine's accent, say his name, Michael Caine. But for oh man, I started watching that, my girlfriend and I were watching it, and I didn't even make it through the first disc of the first, well, I guess it was the Two Towers we were watching, but I didn't make it very far. I fell asleep. I enjoyed every minute of it, then I fell asleep. One does not simply. Or what about when Strider or whatever, he kicks that helmet, and I guess he broke his foot. It is probably what I'm gonna go do next. Just accidentally boot up Overwatch.
Oh no.
That's acting. I should try a stream tomorrow. Maybe. What am I doing? I'm trying to remember what I have going on. What I have going on this weekend. Accidentally. It's so weird being in this other room. So similar. So strange.
Yay, pen pressure is back. Hello, I'm serious. Yeah, I'm listening to thunderstorms. Rain and thunder, thunderbolts of lightning. Things that are very, very frightening.
They are. Oh, probably Set or someone that recommended it. Let's be honest. But thank you. It's seems like an atmosphere people enjoy. I enjoy hanging out with everybody too. Whistle the theme song for X-Files. Your internet is downloading a TV show? Did you tell it to download a TV show? Okay. Is it working now? There we go. Yay, we're back. I forgot what I was saying. But, listen to the... What was I? What did everybody hear last? Is it a YouTube video? There is, I think it was my end messing up. But yeah, there is a new YouTube. There's my YouTube. Oh, I was saying, Seth probably recommended it. And I didn't want copyrights, and I wanted something more relaxing. I kept getting copyrighted for other stuff I was using, and I wanted the videos to be able to stay up and things like that, so people could watch them later, or I could take them and turn them into speed paints and things like that if I wanted. So some of my subscribers or followers suggested I use this Pure Sound. I wish I could remember who, because then I could give them credit, but yeah. Soft murmur. Yeah, I'm using rainymood.com. Noisily? What's Noisily? Also kind of cool. It's really loud now. How about now? Is that better? Oh, that's cool. I should try some of those other ones out. Is the audio any better now? I'm gonna have to go through and figure out what's wrong with all my stuff. Maybe? So many technical difficulties today. Sorry, everybody. Normally things run a little bit better. This new room is cursed. Well, maybe I'll call it a night for a stream now. Just want to finish this one up a little bit. The ghost of streamers past. Timmy's ghost is haunting us again. He's awakened his spirit and he wants ink. Digital ink. The spirit of ghostly Tim has arisen, and the only thing that'll satisfy his quench is data. I don't know, I might. That's kind of cool. I like this one. Let's see what else we did. Yeah, that's alright. That was pretty cool. I might do this one. I ended up liking a lot more than I did originally. Yeah, I might. Maybe it'll be next week's final. Scary! Spooky, scary skeletons. But yeah, I think I'm gonna take a break. Well, I'm gonna head out. Probably go play some Overwatch. Thanks, Seth. Thank you. Let me make some soft murmur. I will add that to the mix. Do you know if those have any kind of copyright? I wonder if I can play that. Seems like it'd probably be alright. Okay. I'm gonna call this one done for now. Yeah, I might take this one to the next level. I kind of like it. Hey, Ryan Trost. Yeah, I'm glad you made it. Really appreciate everyone stopping by.
It's been a really fun stream, even though we've had some technical difficulties.
Okay, as long as it's not copyrighted. Ah, thank you. Thank you, Harem King. Thanks for stopping by. Aw, thanks everybody. I appreciate everybody coming by. Hopefully next time I won't have as many technical difficulties. This one has been just filled with them. As you know, the curse and all that. So, yeah, I'll be back. Oh, really? You did? Ooh. That's awesome. I'd be interested in seeing what you did. That's cool. Do you know which office? Which location? You can send me a private message or something on Twitter or such. Oh yeah, and check out my YouTube, youtube.com/TimKaminski. More videos and stuff there. Oh, the Atlanta studio? Okay, cool. And if anyone wants to get a hold of me really fast and all that stuff, check out my Twitter. I'm gonna post in a second. Yeah, here it is. And there's my Twitter. And I respond really fast on there, so just send me a private message if you're But yeah. Bye, everybody. Take care. Have a good night.